Welcome to the program. Today's our topic of discussion is Muslim education. We will also know its features, aims, process of education and curriculum. So let's start without any wastage of time. Muslim education. During a medieval period, Muslim rulers started a new system of education which is popularly known as Maktaba Madrasa system of Muslim education. Side by side, the old Pathshala system of education also continued for Hindu students. We shall discuss the Muslim system of education in detail. Let's know about the chief characteristics of Muslim education. Patronage of the rulers. The rulers helped in the spread of the education of a Muslim. They built educational institutions and universities, and also they endowed them with the funds, and the big landlords also provided financial help for the spread of Muslim education, and the rulers patronized the men of learning. No state control. The rulers neither claim any authority over the educational institutions nor interfere with the management. Talking about religion dominated education, in the words of S.N. Mukherjee, he says that the whole educational institutions was saturated with the religious ideals, which influenced the aim that the contests of the study and even the daily life of the pupils. The pupils acquired knowledge as a religious obligation. Countryside as the center of education. By and large, educational institutions flourished in the countryside. Provision of various disciplines through education was primarily religion oriented. It included the study of many intellectual activities like mathematics, astronomy, grammar, polity and politics. Also, arts and literature were also encouraged. Talking about norms of conduct, adequate stress was laid on the well-defined norms and behaviors of pattern, and also the pattern of thought, building a personality and character of the pupils. Teacher-pupil relationship in the Muslim period. Also, the teachers were preached as during the Brahmanic and Buddhist period. Respected. So there was an intimate relationship between teacher and the pupil. Although the practice of living with the teacher was not as common with the Muslim as it was in the case of Brahmanic and Buddhist period. Learned teachers. Teachers took to teaching for love. They were held in high esteem. According to Prof. S.N. Mukherjee has observed, learning was prized for its own sake and as a mark of the highest human development, and teaching was never handicapped by examination recruitments. Individual instructions. Since the number of students with the teacher was limited, he paid an individual attention to each student. Monitorial system. Although a teacher did not have many pupils to teach yet, still the teacher would take the help of the senior and advanced students to teach the younger or the junior students. Talking about discipline, punishment were quite severe. Truants and delinquents were caned on their palms and slapped on their faces. A strange mode of punishment was to make the children hold their ears by taking their hands from under their thighs while sitting on their tiptoes. Talking about types of institutions, primary education was imparted in maktabas and secondary education and higher education in madrasas. Vocational education. So provision was also made for vocational, technical and professional education. As we know that Emperor Akbar took considerable interest in the education, as in the evident from the passage from the Annie Akbar. The passage makes interesting reading and provides valuable information on the system of instruction, that is curriculum, methods of teaching. Talking about the chief features of primary and elementary Muslim education. First one is institution of primary education. So the primary education was imparted through the maktabas and were attached with the mosque, or were independent of the mosque, khanqahs of the saints. Also, at some places served as centers of education. Similar, learned men also taught students at their residences. talking about the financing of maktabas. Most of the maktabas were either patronized by the rulers, had endowment, they depended on the charity of, and also they depended on the charity of philanthropists. Talking about the management of the maktabas were run under the guidance of the learned maulvis. They were supposed to be very pious. Talking about the curriculum varied from place to place, but the teaching of alphabets and the recitation of Quran was almost compulsory. The students learned some portions of the Quran by heart, and this was considered essential to perform religious functions. Talking about language, Arabic and Persian languages were mostly compulsory for getting high government posts. On one had to learn these languages. Talking about the fee, there were several village schools where the students were required to pay their instructions not in cash but in kind. Talking about the orphanages, which is orphan students, the state set up some orphanages where the children received education free of charge. Vast endowments were made for these orphans. So age of admission. At the age of 4 years, 4 months and 4 days, Maktaba ceremony or Bismillah was performed to indicate the beginning of the child's education. This was considered as an auspicious moment for initiation of starting education. Good wishes were offered to the child. Surah Iqra, a chapter from the Holy Quran, was recited on this occasion. Education of sons of nobles and rulers. The Muslim nobles as well as the rulers engaged daughters to teach their children at their homes. Widespread of maktabas. Almost every village had at least one maktaba. There were several maktabas in towns and cities. Talking about the aims of education and curriculum. So the main aim of Muslim education was to spread Islamic culture and religion. So the first one is development of knowledge. By knowledge, they meant material knowledge as well as spiritual knowledge. By spiritual knowledge, they meant the knowledge of the Islam. Second, spread of Islamic culture and Islamic religion. They emphasized on the education of Islamic culture and Islamic religion since they firmly believed in it. So talking about third, development of character and morality. So they want to develop Islamic morality among the students and development of character. So in this case of any misconduct, there was a provision of repentance on the basis of Islamic rules. Talking about loyalty to the government, since they are foreigners, they wanted to make the Indian loyal to the government of education. Talking about education of arts and skills and vocation, since almost all the Muslim rulers were great lover of the arts and crafts, they laid emphasis on the education of arts and crafts. Simultaneously, education of different vocations was also organized, which resulted in the economic growth of the country. Talking about curriculum, so the Muslim education in the medieval period was divided into two levels, primary education and higher education. Talking about curriculum at primary level, knowledge of alphabets, teeth section of Quran, reading, writing, mathematics, letter and application writing, and the way of conversation, special practice in proper pronunciation and good handwriting were given to the children. Talking about curriculum at higher level, the curriculum was divided into two categories, worldly and religion. Talking about the worldly curriculum, Arabic and Persian languages and their literature, mathematics, geometry, history, geography, economics, political science, as you see, astrology, Islamic law, Yunani medicine, and various arts and skills. So talking about the religious curriculum, Quranic study, Islamic history, Islamic literature, Sufi literature, and Islamic law. So during those days, there was no printed books for the beginners. Wooden books, taqeeds, were used. So the Quran, after alphabets, words were taught to students, citrus on so also they laid the citrus on calligraphy. Beautiful and fine handwriting was an important element of instruction. Teaching of grammar was taught, as it was considered very valuable in teaching the language. So also the religious instructions imparted in the maktabas were religious through and through. So the books other than Quran, after the Quran, the Gulistan and the Bostan poems of the وایٹ فردوسی وایر ٹیکن اپ پہارس اسٹوڈنٹس آلسو لرنڈ پہارس ملٹیپل آف نمبرس سو اسٹوڈنٹ میمورائزڈ دیز وائل اٹرنگ کولیکٹو ان اے لاؤڈ وائس ٹاکنگ اباؤٹ دی میتھڈس آف ٹیچنگ ان دی مسلم ایجوکیشن ڈفرنٹ ٹیچنگ میتھڈس وائر اڈاپٹیڈ ٹو ٹیچ ڈفرنٹ سبجیکٹس ایٹ ڈفرنٹ لیولس لائک پرائمری لیول دی ٹیچنگ میتھڈ وائر اڈاپٹیڈ وائر دی امیٹیشن پریکٹس اینڈ میمورائزیشن ایٹ ہائر لیول سپیچ لیکچر ایکسپلینیشن میتھڈ وائر اڈاپٹیڈ ٹو ٹیچ سبجیکٹ لائک فلاسفی لاجک اینڈ مینی میتھڈس واز یوزڈ اینڈ آلسو دی سیلف اسٹڈی میتھڈ واز اڈاپٹیڈ فار ہائر لیول اینڈ ٹو ٹیچ دی ایکٹیویٹی اورینٹیڈ سبجیکٹس لائک کرافٹس آرٹس سکلس اینڈ ادر ووکیشن ڈیمونسٹریشنس ایکسپیریمنٹ اینڈ پریکٹس میتھڈس وائر اڈاپٹیڈ Talking about the discipline in the medieval period, discipline referred to being the teachers as complaints to the rulers of the maktabas and madrasas. Corporal punishment was given. At the same time, there was a provision of a reward for disciplined students. Talking about teachers, ustad, people well versed in Islamic religion and scholars of Arabic and Persian or other subjects could become teachers. They receive high salary and they possess high status in the society. Talking about the students, shagird, the students lived under the strict control and discipline of the teachers. They lived in a highly authoritative and oppressive condition. They lived a sophisticated life in the hostels. In hostels, they have very good infrastructure facilities and very delicious food were provided. So talking about the teacher-taught relationship, teacher loved their students and taught them with great concern. So students also respected their teachers and obeyed them devotedly, and the students obeyed the teachers out of the fear in the medieval period. Talking about the madrasa and maktaba, the maktabas were primarily schools meant for all small children. Maktabas means a place where reading and writing is taught. Students were admitted in maktabas at the age of 4 and 4 months and 4 days. At the time of admission, bismillah ceremony were a solemnized in the maktaba. Every student was made to learn verses of the Quran, Islamic religion, Arabic, Persian and mathematics. Talking about the madrasa, madrasa means to deliver speech. Higher education was given in madrasas. It is located either in a state capital or in a big cities. Contemporary kings or emperors contributed a lot in the establishment of madrasas, their building, libraries and hostels, etc. The chief aim of establishing these centers was the preservation and spread of Islamic religion and culture. So the medium of instruction in these days was the Arabic and Persian languages. Talking about the other aspects of education, the concept of mass education was something inconceivable in the medieval period, since their aim is to spread Islam and its culture. So only 6% of the population was literate. Both girls and boys were educated in maktabas and ladies were forbidden from entering madrasas. They made best arrangements for the education of different arts, crafts and skills and vocations in madrasas. Only Islamic religion was taught. At the conclusion, we say that it is a retrogressed. One may say that Muslim education was an exotic plant in India. It failed to benefit the Indian to get to the extent to which an education system of the society should have been. Some of the good aspects like free education, state patronage, regular financial and aid to the educational institutions have been practiced in the modern system of education. I hope you find this video informative. Thanks for watching. Give thumbs up.